the fairest flower in Yarrow, and she refused nae nobleman for a ploughboy from Gala. Then up bespoke her father dear, who brought them all the sorrow, saying, send him forth for to fight the nine on the dewy dens of Yarrow. She kissed his lips and combed his hair, her heart being full of sorrow. Then she set him on her milk-white steed, which bore him down to Yarrow. As he came o'er yon high hill, down by the horns of Yarrow, there did he see the nine lords all, but there wasn't one his marrow. He said, you're nine and I'm but one, in that there's not much marrow, yet I will fight ye man for man to gain the flower of Yarrow. Then three he slew, and three withdrew, and three lay deadly wounded, when her brother John stepped in between, and he stuck his knife right through him. He never spoke more words than these, and these were words of sorrow. You can tell my true love if you please, I'm sleeping sound in Yarrow. They took this young man by the heels and trailed him like a harrow, and then they flung this comely youth in a whirlpool. A dream of dew and sorrow, I dreamed that you were spilling blood on the dewy dens of Yarrow. Oh, sister dear, I read your dream, I doubt it will bring sorrow. You may go and seek your true lover home, for he's sleeping sound in Yarrow. As she went o'er yon high hill, down by the horns of Yarrow, there did she see her old true love lying deeply drowned in Yarrow. This fair maid's hair being three quarters long, the colour it was yellow, she tied it around his middle waist and drew him out of Yarrow. She kissed his lips and combed his hair, as oft she'd done before. Then she laid him on her milk-white steed, which bore him home from Yarrow. daughter dear, wipe up your tears and weep no more in sorrow, for I will bring you to a higher degree than a ploughboy from Gala. Oh, hold your tongue, my father dear, I cannot help my sorrow, for a flower like my own true love will never bloom in Yarrow. This fair maid, she being tall and slim, the fairest maid in Yarrow, she laid her head in her father's arms, and she died in grief.